Alright, hello, welcome back. What's up? I've been spending the last couple of days going through and rewriting all of my scripts to make them all nice and human readable. I've gone through, as you can see, there's like little labels everywhere that kind of like explain what everything do. And what I've done is I've done and gone through every single one of them, rewritten every single script to make sense and also not be like all jumbled mess. Like before we had stuff randomly pasted in random places. Now everything actually makes like logical, physical sense. So we're just going to quickly go through what everything does now. And in addition to that, I've also actually made a little zip pack, which I will upload to Dropbox. So if you want to install everything all in like one big go and without having to go through Pastebin, you can do that now. The link will be in the description, of course. But we can start up today with Scout. I've made many, many little minor quality of life improvements. For example, one thing I've done is I found a script and installed it and everything, so you can use the number pad on your keyboard. If you've got a large keyboard, you can use the number pad to quickly switch between classes. Quite useful, I'd say, especially if you're playing like sixes or something, you're holding last, and you know you need to quickly switch to sniper. You know, as you're going into spawn, quickly mash A and there you are, you're a sniper. Very useful. It's way faster than, you know, coming in here, pressing comma, pressing sniper. So there you go, another little quality of life. One of the other things I've done is I've added F1 to F4. Now lets you switch between loadouts. So if you have different loadouts for different things, for example on Scout I've got the kind of, you know, normal sixes, pistol, scattergun, Boston Basher, and then I've also got like the Highlander one with the milk and the atomizer, and one specifically to show off on this video with secondary use weapons. But you could use that on all the classes. For example, if you're playing Medic, where it comes in especially handily, is if, for example, here, let's see, let's get a bit quick Uber charge. So, you know, you've got an Uber charge, and you want to switch spawns. So this is, say, this is a forward spawn, and you don't want to drop your Uber, but you want to spawn over there, which is where you should. You quickly press on your loadout switch again, and there you go. You've immediately spawned, and you've still got your Uber. And the way this works is, normally, you'd have to, like, change a hat or something, and it'll change you back. However, if you instead press your loadout key, like that, well, you can't see because I'm standing still, look. It should spawn you back. It doesn't normally work, though. So just having a button that does it makes it insanely useful. So if you want to switch to crits, you can also do that. All's good. I've got loadouts for all the mediguns, just in case I need them. So if, you know, I was playing, you know, I've been playing medic, our team dies, we dropped a Uber, I can quickly spawn, press F2. There we go, I've got crits now, and I can get back into the action. Very useful little thing. And I'm not sure. There's also a couple of little things. So I've changed the square left and right bracket a little bug fixy things, as I'll show. In all of the scripts, let's go down to the bottom here, there's this little bug fixing buttons example. The left bracket is kind of a, you know, not as heavy a fix, it's just HUD reload scheme, so stay, sometimes like your health doesn't show properly or there's a little bug, you know, your health's red or something, you just simply press left bracket, it'll pause and reload your HUD. And a little bit more of a major bug fix is the kind of help me button I've written, and what it does is it does the record demo stop thing, which fixes most bugs. So for example, you're playing against invisible players, or your HUD's really broken, fixes that. Sound restart, in case, you know, like a minigun sounds keep going off and off and off. And also HUD reload scheme, just in there as a thing. So, you know, if your game's completely broken, mash that key, take a couple of seconds, and it will reload everything, and it should all work perfectly. Very useful. So it means you don't have to keep going into console and typing in, you know, record demo stop. Should help. And then I don't think there's many other little quality of life. The rest of it is quite similar, and I'll go through them quickly in case, well, chances are, you know, you don't have to go watch through the other video. I'll quickly go over them. So on, this is the kind of general layout of the class scripts. We've got Scout, Soldier, Pyro, Demo Man, Heavy Weapons, Engineer, Medic, Sniper, Spy. They all start out with a little thing here. So, for example, if there's a bug in these that I haven't seen yet, but I fix them at a later point, you can find on Pastebin the Scout CFG and then look for changes and install those yourself. So it means you don't have to keep coming back to the video or, you know, anything like that. I've also made it so it's nice and simple to see where the reset binds are. So this little section here goes through here, rebinds everything to stock. And this little section here is the weapon switches and stuff. So I've got it very clearly laid out as the primary weapon script, secondary, melee, activate secondary, milk, and also the binds. And if you really want to, you can change these around. For example, if you don't have a 6-5-6 button mouse, you can change mouse 4 and mouse 5 here to say like Q&E. So for example, if you want to keep using the script. So it should all be quite easy to modify now, very readable. And if you're not sure how my Scout script works, it still works in the same way as it always has. So you press left click to switch to the scatter gun and switch it, and you shoot it like this. You right click, and also, if you want, press right click to shoot with the pistol. You middle click, and again, press middle click with the melees to use it. You know, quite usual stuff for me. If I switch to the show off loadout, I've also got mouse 4 bound to secondary. So if I've got the Sandman out, let's actually quickly build a thing. If I've got the Sandman out, I can press mouse 4 to fire off the Sandman. Now if I build up a atomizer charge quickly, I can also press mouse 4 to use the atomizer charge. And in addition, I've also got mouse 5 bound, so if I want to, I can hold that down, immediately throw milk as fast as Scout can, without having to press 2 and then left click. I can just literally hold down a button and it throws it for you. And then it switches back to your scattergun. Very useful stuff, indeed. As you can see, all very usable. So if you don't want to switch anything up, say, you know, you don't think you'll use that milk bind, but you do have your push-to-talk bound to F5, you can just simply go here and set this to nothing. So if you say, if in a TF2 script it says bind a key to nothing, it just won't do anything. So if that's your push-to-talk, that's all you have to do. And also under generic stuff, I've, you know, put my personal settings, the ones I like. So since I use the White Trium or Yttrium view model mod, as I've labelled at the top, as in addition to linking the video, so if you want to install it yourself, I've got view models on all the time because the mod handles everything. I've got view model FOV on 90 because the mod doesn't allow any higher and I like high view model FOV. FOV desired on 90 because everyone really should play on high view high FOVs. I've got my crosshair in here, so if you don't want this messing with your own crosshair, just comment it out like this and save it. I've got the cart outline glow enabled now because with transparent view models, if you disable view models temporarily, I'll try it now, see if it'll work. I'm not sure. View models 0. I'm not sure. It makes the screen dark sometimes with transparent view models and disabling view models. But since I don't disable them now, it's not a problem. But the fix to dark screens with transparent view models was just to disable the outline glow. So like, you know, on Intel and payload carts, if you disable that, I previously had F bound to quickly show if there was an outline. I don't have to do that anymore. I just have them on all the time. That's quite cool. Look in the bottom left. The flames are going through the old railings there. Anyway. And in addition, I've also got don't show the FPS, auto reload on, don't show tracers. Don't think it should matter with the view model mod, but it's nice to have just in case. It means you don't see these scattergun shots firing off. You literally just see the bullet holes. Also, you'll see when I shoot a wall, if you have a look, there's no smoke particles or anything. That's because I've got the surface properties.txt mod installed. Very, very, very simple mod to install. It's this. there's literally tutorials on it everywhere. You literally get a text file and you drop it in your custom folder or something along those lines. If I can find a tutorial on it, I will and post it in the description. If not, maybe I'll make like a 60-second on it later. But yes, very important for me because, if I'm honest, smoke doesn't really add much to the game. I can see the bullet holes, I can see that I've hit. I don't need to have all these particles clogging up my frame rate and everything. So that's an important thing to note. And HUD fast switch 1, so that's, if you've only just gotten the game or maybe you've never changed it, you'll see every time you change weapons normally, there's stuff on the right and you have to like click every time you change weapons. Fast switch gets rid of that, so I can just go between weapons as fast as I like. And that's the Scout, basically. Very simple, very usual. If you want to change anything, you can, very easily. We'll move on to the Soldier. It's, again, quite similar. I've changed a few things around. So, quickly press 2 on my numpad, because I can do that now. Left click, as it always has been, is shoot rockets and switch to the rocket launcher. 2, shotgun. Shoot the shotgun. 3, melee. Usual stuff. A lot of my scripts have this kind of one button to switch to and one button to fire that weapon, because I like being able to use the weapon that I want at the time I want it. I don't want to have to, you know, press right click and then press left click to use the shotgun. I'd rather just right click. It makes more sense to me. Anyway, if we switch to the cow mangler, which I believe is on this loadout. No, this one? Okay, this looks like a cow mangler. Okay, I can mash F5 quickly and it will shoot the cow mangler. I believe that's the only alt-fire weapon the Soldier has, but if you want to use the Cow Mangler, it's perfectly fine to use now. It's basically just the stock launcher that can't destroy sentries, since the buff. That's useful. And in addition, because I don't main Soldier, I've always used a jump crouch script. So as you see, if I hold down space, my guy crouches. But it basically means I can jump up these little ledges without having to jump crouch. It's just a little quality of life thing I've always had. However, the thing is, it screws up with a lot of rocket jumps. So as you can see, a normal rocket jump height for me is roughly there. I bound just from mouse 4 to a regular hop. I don't necessarily think you should use it. If you want a main Soldier, I would recommend just not using a jump crouch script on this class. So if you go onto Soldier, you'll see normal jump is literally just plus jump. Whereas if we go over to null move, space is normally bound to crouch jump, which is jump and duck. What I would recommend doing on Soldier is just right here where it says norm jump, just write bind space. And that will mean every time you jump, you'll not do a jump crouch. However, if you're like me and you don't really care, I've left in... Oh, hello. I've left in a mouse 4. So if you really want to do little hops like this, this is a normal jump and a normal rocket. This is a crouch jump and a rocket. So you can see, it's nice to have both options. So all I have to do is press mouse 4 and left click rather than space and left click. It's, you know, I use it occasionally, but it's not the most impressive thing in the world. Because, you know, when I play Soldier, I know how to rocket jump up somewhere. There's probably more efficient ways, you know, with C-tapping and stuff. But there you go. I've left that in just in case you want to have a normal jump available on Soldier. And in addition, you know, you can switch between the loadouts. So you've got your normal, you know, your normal kind of pocket loadout, your normal kind of roamery loadout, and your Contra loadout, and your pissing around loadout. It's nice to be able to switch between them just with a button, I think, anyway. And we move on to Pyro, which, if you haven't seen before, is a very, very odd script for me, but I've always really liked it. It really exemplifies the kind of one button for each thing. I've got left-click bound to flamethrower and flames, right-click bound to flamethrower and airblast, mouse 4 bound to shotgun and use, mouse 5 bound to melee. So what I normally do is as I run around, I'll quickly press mouse 5, run around fast with the power jack, and then when I see someone, I'll hold down left click, tap right click, and then mouse 4. It works for me, basically. Since I have both the airblast and the flamethrower bound to the first mouse buttons, I can always airblast. I can just go here, double click right click, and airblast. I don't have to like press 1 and right click. It makes more sense for me. If it doesn't work for you, you're welcome to mess around with the script. It will be very easy to do. You simply have to change some of these around. They should all hopefully be quite readable. So here, for example, it says airblast, switches to flamethrower, airblasts. If you don't want it to switch to flamethrower, you just remove the slot 1, and all it will do is a normal right click. Plus attack 2 is normal right click. But, you know, I like being able to switch to the flamethrower, so I've left that in. And that's kind of it for the pyro loadout. It's all kind of the same. I want to quickly show off the detonator, which I believe I have on 3. Here we go. Middle click. Middle click's not a button I use a lot, so I had it bound to detonate. So if you want to use the detonator, you can shoot it with mouse 4, detonate it with middle click. Not the most pressing matter, to be honest, because, you know, the detonator, it's fun, but you're not going to use it all the time unless you really want to. But if you do, you can use it. It is available. The option is there. Switch on to demo. By far, my, like, most defaulty kind of script. As you can see, it's all incredibly normal. Left click is bound to attack. Right click is bound to attack 2. Melee is bound to slot 3, and that's it. That demo is very, very simple for me. Go back to demo like this. So as you can see, I scroll up for grenades. I'm still scrolling up, and I'm still on the grenades. Scroll down is always to stickies, so I like having the options. I don't have to switch through all the melee every time. I can just know if I want to grenade a guy, I just scroll up, boom. I can grenade the man. If I want to do stickies, I scroll down, and then I can shoot stickies. Everything else is very, very normal, you know? Right, left click to shoot. You can hold down right click and shoot left click if you want to spam stickies like this. If you want to, you can hold down middle click to spam your melee weapon. It doesn't really matter. Just you can also left click to use your melee on this class, because I'm a wacky kind of person. Just because I thought it was a bit weird on this class not having anything bound to mouse 4 or mouse 5. Okay, great. I've also got that jump thing from Soldier. So instead of, you know, I normally do a sticky jump like this. Gets to about here. About there. You can also, if you really want, press mouse 4 and right click, and you'll get to, like, there. So there you go. You've got the normal jump on demo, in case you want to do a demo sticky jump with just a regular one. There you go. We can try engineer. Or heavy, actually. Let's do heavy. Do them in order. Heavy, again, quite simple, but a couple little extra little things. So I've got mouse wheel up to the sandwich, mouse wheel down to the fists, and middle click to the minigun. For some reason, I've always really liked having middle click to your primary weapon on heavy. Not sure why. I'm a bit of an odd person, maybe, but I like being able to scroll down to run and then mash middle click to get my minigun out. Other than that, very normal. You know, you can also use the number keys if you really want to. In any of the classes, number keys should always work. But on heavy specifically, I've got some sandwich scripts. So as long as you're not spun up, you can... Oh, he's eating. Let's give him a second. Great. As long as you're not spun up, hold down mouse 4 to throw a sandwich, and then you'll immediately... Look at it. Oh, shit. It's going on an adventure. Never mind. And if you want to, you can also hold down mouse 5 to eat the sandwich. Useful little sandwich scripts. If you really, really want to, as you know, these are nice and editable, you could, if you really want to, add on to the throw bind a little semicolon, meaning next line, and then add in echo sandwich throne. And then that means, if I execute the heavy round, nom 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 nom, as you can see, when I throw a sandwich, it says... in console, sandwich throw. Well, actually, I need to do echo, not echo. Say sandwich throw. That's wrong. Echo is just to write into the console. Say is to say into chat. So if I hold down mouse 4 and throw it, now it says in chat, sandwich thrown, sandwich thrown, ah. I wouldn't recommend it, but if you really want to, you can have that in there. I'm just going to have it on normal, though. Also, as you can see, actually, I'll get to this later. Let's just go into the NG. Do everything nicely and in order. So yes, heavy, normal kinds of things. Minigun, it's all very normal. If you really want to do the sandwich throwing, you just hold down mouse 4, and it's like that, and off it goes. Engineer, wrong class, there we go. Quite simple indeed. Scroll up for shotgun, scroll down for pistol, middle click for wrench. I've always liked that as a loadout for engineer. I like, as I've said, I like having one button for one weapon. So if I want a shotgun, I scroll up, shotgun. If I want a pistol, I scroll down and pistol. If I want a melee, I middle click and left click. And also on engineer, I've got a mouse 4 bind. If I want to quickly build a mini, so I want to run around here and just quickly, I've got my shotgun out, put a mini down quickly behind me, ooh, like this. Very useful little bind. Mouse 4, you just hold it down. I don't think I have mouse 5 bound to anything on engineer, I believe. You have a little check? No, but I do have a cool little Eureka effect script. I don't have it equipped on anything. Let's equip it now. So the Eureka effect is a very interesting little weapon, if you've never used it. It lets you teleport to either your exit or your entrance. So you, if you want, you can normally, with these binds that I've made, normally you have, think you have to press like G or H or something, and it's just a mess. I've made a, when they made the change, I made a very, very simple little script, as you can see here. So what you want to do, it doesn't matter what weapon you've got out, press Q and spam it, and you will teleport to the spawn. And that's great, you say, but how do I go to my exit? That's simple, you just crouch and then press Q. And you go straight to the exit. Very, very useful bind. I don't use the Eureka effect a lot because they kind of made it really bad for some reason. But it means that if you really want to, anytime you can just go back to spawn by pressing Q. Or go to your teleporter by crouching and pressing Q. It means you don't have to mess around with fiddling around with a little menu. You can always get to where you want at any point. But yeah, very good little thing. I'd highly recommend it. Even if you don't use it, like the whole script, highly recommend looking into the little Eureka effect script I've got here. Let's have a quick look at Medic. Medic script is very much still very similar to Chris's script from like 7 years ago or something. Quite messy, I have to say, but I've tried to neaten it up as much as I can. But as you can see, it's got some very interesting little bits and bobs in it. So I've got, let's get myself a friend in here. Okay, like if I, doesn't matter what weapon I've got out, blah 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 blah. Hold down left click and it will heal the guy. I don't use the auto heal, so if I let go of left click, it lets go. That's what I've always used. I've never really liked the lock. So that's how I have it. If I want to, I can also press right click, and then right click again, and then you'll shoot an arrow. And if I want to, I can press middle click, and middle click. So we can just quickly build an Uber. There we go. Thank God for the Uber saw. This would take like 60 seconds every time. If I want to use my Uber charge, I quickly press mouse 4. And I can play the pretty hard. Normally I switch to the medigun because I'm healing someone. Then you press mouse 4. And you'll have heard that he didn't hear the, you know, yelling that you normally get with an Uber. He actually just said, you know, a quiet voice line, like Schweinhunds or Danke Dunkoffs, you know, very quiet little voice line. So that's a kind of a Uber charge quiety script. It'll give you another couple of seconds of safety. Very useful thing to have. I've also got an F on Medic. He says a random voice line. So if I'm about to hit full Uber, quickly build one again. So I'm about to build an Uber. When I get to about 99%, I press F. And that Oktoberfest voice line that you just said, or, you know, whatever voice line happens to happen. Because I was making a voice line beforehand, and I've got the quiet voice lines bound to F, as you can see, random voice 1 to 6, it's the two, it's the voice menu 2s, I'm not sure what those are, I think they're just like, yeah, they're cheers, it's cheers. So when you press F, he randomly says a cheer, and that covers up the I'm fully charged voice line. Incredibly useful. If you're playing Medic, always, always use something along those lines, or at least, you know, say a voice line before you've got an Uber, and that way, as you can hear, there's literally no voice line when I use an Uber charge. And the beam kind of comes from, like, here. Quite funky. I quite like that. Quite like a thin beam. That's a result of the ViewModel script, though. Quite cool. And in addition, I've also got, I believe, yes. When you pull out your, as you see the little beeping there, when you pull out your, I don't want to say primary, like your shot, when you pull out your primary weapon or your crossbow, whatever, it'll make a little beep appear above all of your teammates' heads, like a little radar, as you can see, if they're in line of sight. A very, very useful little thing. Chris always had it in his scripts, and I always found it incredibly useful. So, by default, people only auto-call at 50 health, so if this engineer was really hurt, he would have the normal beep, but when I pull up my crossbow, even if he's fully buffed, he'll have the beep above his head. Quite useful if you're playing medic and you want to know, you know, you've got your arrows out, you want to see who can I arrow. As you can see, there's a little thing on the screen. Even though he's at full health, it shows that thing on the screen telling me to look left. There he is. I'm going to shoot him in the face with an arrow. Very useful. I would highly recommend it. Or something along those lines. And we can go on to Sniper now. Is that not Sniper? That's Sniper. Again, quite a simple script. Sniper, I mostly just use the sniper rifle. I don't really use the secondaries very much. Shoot him in the bum quickly just to get him going. Oh, you also can see the glow through the walls. Quite cool. I don't normally have that enabled, but since I've got it now, I always remember that I can see people through walls and it feels a bit weird. But anyway, sniper. Left click does what it normally does. You know, right click does what it normally does. And that's about it, really. I've got scroll up bound to... Actually, let's switch to a different loadout. It'll make a bit more sense than the Razorback. If I want to, I can scroll up for... the sniper rifle, I believe. Yeah, scroll up for the sniper rifle or middle click and scroll down for the melee. And if I want to use Jurati, I can either press 2 and throw it like a normal person, or I can hold down mouse 5 like I had on Scout with the milk. It's a similar bind, if not the exact same. So if I want to, I can hold down mouse 5 and he'll throw Jurati. Very good. And that's about it, really. I've also got mouse 5 bound to automatically pull out your melee and swing it. So if I want to, with two buttons, I can switch to Jurati, throw it, and then press another button and hold it down. If I could, I could catch up to him and swing it. Quite a useful little thing to have, I'd say. And also there's two ways to switch to the sniper rifle, just in case you're in a kind of a dodgy situation, you're jumping around and then a scout jumps into you, all you have to do is scroll up or middle click and then you can be like, shoot him. Very good. And the final class config for today, at least, is the spy loadout. I've made it very nice and neat now. Oh, look at it. It all makes sense now. There's no more... I had like a random... disguise script or something. I never used it, and I also had like mouse 4 bound to something that didn't exist, so a bit odd, but as you can see, it all runs along the same kind of idea. I'll quickly go over these quick disguises once I've done with this. So as I always have, scroll up for the gun, scroll down for knife, hold down mouse 5, do you mind, hold down mouse 5 for the sap, so if I want to sap something I can hold that down, right click for right click for dead ringer, left click for shoot. Quite usual, useful stuff. I've added some binds and messed around with some stuff. So mouse 4 now automatically disguises you as a, I believe, enemy scout. So if you're running around and you, I don't want to have to... Well, you. I guess it's made for me. So when I don't want to have to press 4-1, I can run around and just quickly press mouse 4. And he'll disguise as a friend, as an enemy scout, which is the disguise I use the most. I've also got a little description in here somewhere. If you want to read through this, it's to why I use various things. If you want to read through it, I'm not going to talk about it now, because if you really want to, you can find out by reading this. But I've also got the ever-useful medigun checking script. So you press 5. You press 5. There we go. Press the wrong button. And he disguises an enemy medic with his medigun out. So what the 5 script does, basically, is it pulls out your sapper, slot 2, and then disguises an enemy medic. Very useful if you're playing competitive. Useless in pubs, for the most part. Unless you're in a really competitive pub. But if you really want to, you just quickly press F5. Bang. There's your medigun out. I've also got F6 bound to... friendly scout. So if I'm pushing the cart, for example, you know, I'm an enemy scout for a bit, and then I see our payload cart right here, I'll go up behind it, press 6, and then push it for a bit with my teammates while disguised as an enemy, as a friendly scout. Quite useful thing to have, I'd say. And I've also got Q bound to undisguise. Always very useful. So, you know, say I'm running around, blah, 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 and my medic starts shooting me. He's not sure if I'm a spy or not. Quickly tap Q, he can see that I'm a friendly spy. I never really was on your side, that's what I'll normally say to him. And then, you know, very useful. Undisguised script, always very useful thing to have. Won't work with the Eternal Reward, because it works by disguising you as a friendly spy. But it will work with all the other knives and all the other loadouts. And that's about it for the spy, I believe. Is there anything else? No? No, nothing else on the spy. So the rest of this is all just normal jargon. So what I've done is I've gone through my auto-exec and made it nice and neat. I've got a launch option sections. So if you want to, you can quickly knit through here and see if there's anything you like. So... the no vid, for example, disables the video on launch. No crash dialogue kind of does what it says. No joy prevents your controller from working. No border. If you really want to, you can use no border and windowed to play in borderless windowed. I just use full screen personally, but it doesn't hurt to have no border in. It doesn't affect the full screen, I believe. And because I've got 144Hz monitor, I've got refresh 144. Usual stuff. You know, this is all, these bits here are for the... no mass acceleration on the mouse. Heap size is for the RAM allocation. So if you've got 16 gigs, you can double that number. If you've got 4 gigs, you can halve that number. If you've got 6, you can halve it again, and then add those numbers together. I believe it's the number of kilobytes the game can use. I'm not sure. I honestly don't remember. I don't really care either too much. Like the game doesn't really use much more than 4 gigs anyway, so it doesn't really matter too much. I've also got my networking stuff in, nicely labelled, so as you can see it's got the usual kind of, my internet and computer are pretty good, so I'm going to use these settings. The smooth zero, it makes a little explanation that if you're using a frag video, you set smooth to 1, if you're playing the game, you set it to 0. If you want to read more into it, you can, but that's just kind of the binary idea of it. I've also got the two different interp settings that most people use. I use 0.35, because it gives you a little buffer. Very good for ambi. But if you want to, like you play soldier or you like knifing people, 0.0152 is there. If you want to switch them around, you just do that. Really simple. If you want to use a different number, you can. Just change it around. I'd only recommend changing it around if you really know what you're doing, though. It's really simple to mess up your game, or at least your network settings. If you screw around too much, it's possible to give yourself like thousands of ping that you didn't need to have. Which is why rate's only set to 60,000, because the game doesn't really need more than that. Some people set it to like a million, and that's just like a huge, huge bad idea. Anyway, I've also got a bit here, configs execution. I've included the modified version of CalManglias that I use. We'll go over that in a little bit. And if you want to switch up between, like if you're making a frag video, as the examples I normally use, you simply comment out max frames, uncomment max quality, and so on. If you still use PRIC, you can uncomment that. I don't personally use it, even though it was better, because the TF2 one just kind of works. I don't want to mess with it too much. I've got the normal mouse settings that I use, you know, the non mouse acceleration stuff, and my sense. So if you don't want this messing with your sensitivity, comment that out or change that to whatever number you use, you know, like 3 or 4 or 10 or whatever, you know. I've got it on 2, so I've just got it in there just to make it look neat and nice. Also under MISC stuff, I've got stuff like SV allow point server command always. If you've played Walkway in the last couple of months and wondered why it doesn't work, it's because Valve added this command, so you have to have this in your auto exec to make Walkway work. Don't know why. I don't know. I think it's just so the server can use your console. I'm not entirely sure though. I've also got the usual kind of view model FOV, volume, disabling health above head, getting rid of your frame rate cap. If you want to cap your frame rate, you just add in like 60 here and your game will be capped at 60. Wouldn't recommend it, but if you don't want like your laptop to overheat or something, that can always be an idea. And disable HTML mod. Zoom sensitivity, I've described it before, I will again though. On Sniper, this game was made for a 4:3 resolution, so the default zoom resolution is made so you go up at a different rate than you expect when you play on a 16:9. Bit hard to describe, but remember that before TF2 was in more of a square resolution, so the sensitivity between vertical and horizontal made more sense. The 0.833333 is what you're meant to use in TF2 and Counter-Strike if you want that kind of 1-1 up and up, down, left, right, in and out of scope. Okay, so if you're wondering why if you scope in and it feels a bit weird, that's because you haven't got this set to the right number. Bit weird that TF2 have done this, but no, most people probably won't really notice. But there you go. Also got sprays disabled. Most servers don't have them on anyway, but I just like not having more frames, to be honest. Showing MVM status, because sometimes it turns off for some reason. I've got chat turned off. I'll go into a little bit, because I've got a little script if you want to enable chat quickly. But basically it just makes it so if someone types something into chat, it immediately disappears. Voice is disabled. Voice scale 1, I mean, you don't really need that, but that makes you so your own microphone set to 100% at all times. I've also got these little aliases built in, so my HUD's been broken for a little while. I can't be bothered to fix it. I tried fixing it, it didn't work. If I want to drop, if I find a new item, all I have to do is type drop into console and it'll drop it. And it's, the actual command is CL trigger first notification. So there you go. And if I'm in like a loading screen, say I'm in a lobby, I can't do it because I'm in a game obviously, but if I'm in a lobby and I want to check my inventory, I just type in inventory and it'll open it up and I can have a little look through. Look at all this paints and stuff I've got. Isn't that great? Hoo-hoo. Wonderful. Great. I did this today. Look, I added loads of like little class icons everywhere. I made everything pretty. Anyway, we'll get onto stuff later. That's not important, to be honest. Transparent view model stuff. You can get rid of this if you don't use them. These three commands here are meant to make it so that TF2 prioritize 50 ping servers, then 75 ping servers, then 100 ping servers when you're connecting to casual and matchmaking, I believe. It might only work with matchmaking though, because it doesn't seem to work for me very much. I still end up on like 300 ping servers from across the sea for some reason. But that's in there just in case they fix it one day, or maybe it does work and I'm a bit stupid. And it's also got the map background preload room built in, so if you use the Whiterium view models, there you go, you can preload by automatically with this. If you don't have the map background preload room, comment that out. If you want to download it, there's a little Dropbox link right here which you can use. And there's also the Yeah, if you want to put these in your launch options as well, I believe at the top I've got it. Here, yeah. There's also plus map background preload room, and you can put that in your launch options instead of this. I have them both in because sometimes it doesn't work when I only have one of them. Bit weird, but it seems to work, having, you know, double layer protection. Anyway, antivirus config. This is what I use. If I'm about to go onto, like, a Skyl server, God help me, or a server with, like, loud adverts, like some MGE servers seem to, like, scream in your ear, I quickly type into console, exec antivirus. I can't type today. I haven't eaten in like a couple good long time. I probably should after this. Anyway, antivirus basically blocks just about everything a server can do to you, other than let you play the game, basically. So it will disable logs. You can't type, like, you know, log into console. That's why I don't have it on default. So if I'm about to, you know, if I'm playing a competitive game, I can still say log in chat like normal. But then if I go to an MGE server, it can't blare adverts in my ears. Very useful little thing to have. But do remember, if you want to look at logs again, just restart your TF2. Because what it does is it basically aliases everything. The server tries to use your console to use the play command to play a sound. And this game, what this script does basically is alias that as just blank. It aliases it as echo blocked play. So every time the server tries to play a sound, instead of trying to play the sound, it just puts a text message into your console saying that the script works. Quite useful. Quite intelligent, actually. Whoever made it. Very smart man. Casual. There you go. The Camanglia's high FPS script that I've got, I've made it all just one big old line. If you want to use it, just use it as it is. I've also given a little description at the top if you want to get more frame rate. But other than that, this is literally just what I use. There's also the max quality script, which is basically just his cinematic one. Very few changes. I might have like one or two, but for the most part, it's just that. Null move. Stolen off, like everyone uses this script, but basically it means you can, instead of when you press A and then press D, it'll normally stop you. Now it just means that if you want to, you can move left and right, forwards and backwards without any pauses by holding down the buttons. Quite useful. And it's also got jump crouch built in, just because I like it. Very useful for mobility. Probably not actually the best idea, but to be honest, I like it and I don't really care that much. In addition, scoreboard config. So you'll wonder why when I press tab, you see all this extra crap on my screen, like in the top right and the bottom right. That's this script. It puts the net graph on the screen, it shows errors, it shows your position, shows your net graph text, makes the net graph text normal size. If you want to make the net graph text small, you use this command here, proportional font, and you think you set that to 1, and it'll make it little. So if we do this and then do exec scoreboard, see the text is now massive. That's not what we want. I like the tiny text, so we set that to 0. And now it's little. Doesn't take as much of the screen, I can still see what my ping and FPS and stuff is. Quite useful. I'd recommend it. No talk and talk are my... So by default I've got chat turned off, so basically you and Y don't do anything, which are the normal chat and team chat things. Voice is disabled and HUD say text time is disabled, so the chat doesn't work. If I want to use the chat, I type in exec talk. And now I can say hello into the chat. And if I want to, I can use my voice. I don't have that really bound, and I don't really use it, but I could if I really wanted to, because talk, as you can see, puts it back to the default of 12. Is it 12 seconds? Something like that. And enables voice, and it rebinds you and Y to work, and also says in console, chat and voice enabled. If I want to disable it again, because I normally have it disabled, I do exec no talk, and as you can see, it prints into console, chat and voice disabled. Very useful. I quite like it. And going on, reaching the end, thank God. We've got the demo viewing config, which I've never really talked about before, but it's something I use very handily. I can't really describe it in game, so I'll just go through the actual notepad file. I've got it so while I'm watching a demo, if I want, I can press 6 to open the demo UI. If you've never seen the demo UI, it looks like this. Can I see it? I didn't write it correctly, it's got an O in it. There you go, that's a demo. That's the demo UI. So if I want to play the demo, you'll normally have to fiddle around with the controls like this, and I never really liked it. So I've got it so 6 opens the demo UI, I press 7 to slow down the game, 8 to normal speed it, and 9 to speed it up. So I've got my finger on those three keys normally, so I can normal speed, super fast speed, super slow speed. Useful for going through it, and it's also got a first person and third person thing, so kind of like frag video-y potential. And it also locks your FOV and view model FOV to 80 because it looks kind of cool in frags. No other reason other than that. It forces view model on, disables voice, disables everything, so it looks nice and cinematic, and also adds a little bit of camera lag in third person. So normally, if I go into third person, it all snaps like that. But if I add in the, where is it? Ideal lag, I believe, once we've done a first person and third person again. As you can see, there's a nice little bit of delay now between the camera moving and between the player moving. I think it looks nicer, personally. Don't have to use it, but that's something I've always liked. And it also re-aliases everything. So this script basically breaks your game until you restart it, but normally if you're recording a demo or... Sorry, if you're looking through a demo or making a frag video, you'll only be opening TF2 for that. But it re-aliases RDraw, remodel, FOV desired, and all that stuff. So anytime in your demo, for example, you open your scoreboard, it will put into the console, you know, it'll try to open the console. So I've re-aliased that to not do anything at all. So Netgraph won't randomly show in the middle of your frag videos when you open your console, and, you know, your view models won't randomly get disabled, even though you tried to force them on earlier. Quite useful. And that's kind of it, basically. I've got a config.cfg. I would not recommend using it, because you'll have your own personal one that TF2 generates for you. But if you want to read through it, just out of curiosity, you can. I've got it in here. You know, maybe if you break yours by accident and you want to see what the normally looks like. But this is literally like the stock TF2 settings plus whatever I changed it to years ago. I've also written a recommendation to never change your config.cfg. So, as in set it to read-only in Windows. It's quite a simple thing to do, if I quickly check. So I'm here in the config folder. We can find config.cfg, you right-click, properties, set it to read-only. And give me a sec, there we go. Now it's set to read-only, you can't change it, the game can't change it, you go into a server that changes your settings and it can't. And it also means my scripts won't change it, so if you want to uninstall them at any point, you just uninstall them. And because your config was set to read-only, my scripts won't have changed your default settings, so you can easily go back to how things were before you had your scripts. Quite useful. Always recommend having that on read-only. Also, because some servers, some very naughty servers, they try to not let you use the antivirus script by blocking it somehow. By messing around with your config. If you set your config to read-only, they can't mess around with any of your settings. So that's always good. And it also means if you look at other people's demos, you don't get forced to use their settings. I've always found that quite annoying.
There you go.
Very good. That's kind of it, though. I've also included in this little zip file, which I'll be uploading, all of these configs that you've got. So if you want to use them, you literally just get all of these, copy, go to your config folder, you know, Steam Apps, Common, Team Fortress 2, TF, CFG, and you just paste them in. You know, very simple stuff. Replace your own ones if you want. Be careful though, make sure you know what you're doing so you don't accidentally rewrite stuff. I'd recommend backing up your config file. Just config, copy, paste. There we go, so that's your backup. I'd recommend keeping a backup just in case I do break your shit, and then all you have to do is go back, delete the new one, and rename this to config. There you go, that's how you fix from a backup. Anyway, that'll be it. I did include a little readme, so if you want to just flick through that, it'll show you, you know, how to install them, where to get updates from if there are little updates, how to install the ViewModel FOV mod, if you want to uninstall it, blah, 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 blah. Tells you what config files are actually included, so if you want to delete them one by one, you can, because it will list them here. But that'll be it. Quite a long, odd video, but it was like highly requested that I went through and did this. So there you go. It's all gone through. If you want to install the new ones, you can. The link will be below in the description if you want to check that out. But that will be it. I will see you all next time. That'll be a goodbye.